Tonight on Access for Award, we hear about the latest residency matches in red carpet fashion. We see how medical students prepare for the next steps as they transition into residency. Students are awarded for their efforts during their last luncheon together. Hoods are placed and hands are shaked in the inaugural class's hooding ceremony. And finally, we celebrate as the graduates receive their diploma. All this and more on Access for Award.
Hello, and welcome to a special edition of Access Fort Worth.
We're here at the beautiful Van Cliver Music Hall on TCU's main campus.
My name is Shelby Wildish. I'm a Dorman Scholar and a recent graduate from the Anne Burnett Marion School of Medicine.
And I'm Ethan Vieira. I'm a rising third year medical student at the Burnett School of Medicine. We're here today to give you the inside scoop on what our amazing inaugural class did before they were off on their residency programs across the United States.
That's right, Ethan. There's a lot to celebrate and a lot to be grateful for. Before we dive into it, why don't we hear from our pre-show red carpet correspondents downstairs, Natalie and Sarah.
Thanks, Ethan and Shelby, and welcome to Access Fort Worth Red Carpet Show. My name is Sarah Lyon. I'm a Dorman Scholar and recent graduate.
And I'm Natalie Shear, another recent graduate. The past few weeks have been a whirlwind of excitement for our entire class of new MDs. As Ethan and Shelby said, the past few weeks have been very busy, from transition to residency, to senior luncheon, to the commencement ceremony, and hooding.
And we'll get to all of that, but first, we have our classmate, Brendan Mallory.
Hey, guys.
Oh my gosh, look at this suit jacket. Amazing.
Of course. I have to ask you, what are you wearing?
Actually, I don't remember where I got this. Maybe Men's Warehouse?
Honestly, I don't remember where I got this either. I think it was a gift.
Well, you both look great, but I really want to hear about Brandon's next chapter, which is emergency medicine residency in New York City. How are you feeling?
Yeah, I'm so excited. I matched at New York Presbyterian, Cornell in Columbia, and I'll be spending the next 4 years, you know, learning medicine in one of the greatest cities in the world, and just so excited to start a new adventure. What about you? You guys also matched at amazing programs.
Yeah, I'm going to be starting general surgery residency at Case Western, and I couldn't be more excited. I get to finally realize my dream of becoming a surgeon.
I'm also very excited to start emergency medicine residency at Boston Medical Center. Excited to head back up to the Northeast and to have some real winters. Really excited for this next chapter of my life, but I will be missing you guys quite a bit.
And what are you going to miss most, Brandon?
I agree with Natalie. I'm going to miss my classmates the most. You guys have like studied with me and supported me and pushed me and inspired me, honestly, over the past 4 years. And I'm so excited to see all the great programs that we landed at. And I'm going to continue to follow everyone's career.
Thank you, Sarah and Natalie, for all your help on the pre-show red carpet. So, Dr. Wildish, you're also off to an amazing residency program. Tell us a little bit about that.
So I actually matched at Tufts Medical Center in Boston for obstetrics and gynecology.
You also went to TCU for undergrad, correct?
I did. So I'm going on 8 years now at TCU with the TCU community.
Wow. What has the Horn Frog community meant to you all these years?
TCU has given me a lot, but I think the people and the mentors I've made along the way have really been the key component of my time here.
Wow, I love that.
The TCU is very intentional with their outreach to the students and the lessons they want to give to them before they head off. One of the things that they were really intentional about was this class called Transitions to Residency to ensure that we were prepared for the next steps. Why don't we hear a little bit more about it from our correspondent and my classmate, Dr. Brianna Collins.
Thank you, Shelby. Hello, everyone. My name is Brianna Collins from the Burnett School of Medicine, and today I'm here to talk to you about our Transition to Residency course. Transition to Residency is a unique course that is designed to really reinforce communication skills and also our clinical skills. Now, we also have an opportunity during this course to practice simulation and to really enhance our procedural skills before starting our intern year of residency. Today, we are fortunate enough to be joined by the Dr. Jennings, who is the course director for Transition to Residency. Hello, Dr. Jennings.
Hey there.
How are you?
Good, how are you doing?
I'm so glad you're here today. So can you tell us a little bit about what it's like for the students?
We have multiple days of high fidelity medical simulation where the students get to practice situations that they may commonly find themselves in internship and residency. Rest of the days are filled with some core clinical content regarding how to prescribe medications, how to pick medications specific to their patients. But then we spend a good bit of time allowing the students to reflect on their journey up till now, as well as start to create a plan on how they become the physician that they've always dreamed of being.
So now tell me, what's your favorite part of the course?
We have a professional identity session where we have one of our experienced clinicians come in and discuss their role as a clinician and a physician. Every student gets to analyze that, think about what they want, and it gave me some time to reflect on that as well.
I'm curious to know, did you have a course like this while you were going through your medical training? And if not, do you think you would have benefited from it?
Oh, I definitely did not have this. Mm-hmm. Yeah, 100% did not. And I felt personally very, very unprepared. Mm-hmm. Looking back on it, it would have made a world of difference for me starting internship day one, mm-hmm. to feel like I had a little bit more confidence in being able to take care of my patients. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Brianna, for all your help. We're now off to the Senior Luncheon, a very special event that honored our graduates before they're off to their residency. And now, let's check in for more details.
The person that you guys voted on to be the inaugural empathetic scholar is Will Mitchell.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, being named Empathetic Scholar for my class, it was just an absolutely tremendous honor. I really was not expecting it. I feel like there's way too many other people in my class who are more deserving of it than me. And the fact it all came from my peers and classmates and closest friends, it really means a lot to me.
And the moment that we've all been waiting for, the hooding ceremony and commencement.
Students, moving forward, when you are wearing your hood at another graduation ceremony, such as this, someone will ask you, where did you go to medical school? You are now forever a Horned Frog and a TCU graduate.
I started my career in healthcare as a housekeeper, but I knew I wanted to be in healthcare. And congratulations to the graduates here because you have made a great decision. It is the profession to be in.
Dr. William Mitchell. Dr. Brianna Nicole Collins, Dr. Grace Ellen Newell.
Yeah, it was really surreal. I mean, we've been working so hard for the past 4 years, if not even longer, and it was just a great moment to finally be dignified as a physician and all the hard work that each and every one of us has done, and it's also a great memory and kind of a signal for us moving forward to wherever we're going as physicians and whatever type of physician we are going to be.
To the extent that I live by these precepts, I shall be a worthy physician.
The world is ready and waiting for you. Congratulations. Go Frogs.
The Burnett School of Medicine was established a few years ago, and today, yeah, we get to graduate the very first class.
It's just surreal, you know, you think that it's never gonna happen because it seems like a distant thing. It's something I knew I was gonna be when I was 5 years old. I was gonna be a doctor.
She drew a picture of her as a doctor with her red purse and her stethoscope around her neck, and she said, this is what a doctor looks like.
And today, I am a doctor.
Introducing Dr. Shelby Billy Elizabeth Wildish. Dr. Samir Alahabadi. Dr. Brandon Nicholas Mallory. Introducing Dr. Faria Kimani. Introducing Dr. Sarah Lyon.
Being part of the first class has been incredible. I am surrounded by truly empathetic scholars and people that are going to be huge change makers in the medical field, and I am so excited that I got to be a part of it.
Well, today is a very wonderful day for me, my family, most certainly for Sarah, and it's wonderful when a parent can see their child's dreams come true. She'll be the best doctor. She's going to be a great surgeon, and I'm very, very proud of her.
So I can catch it. Oh, here we go.
Wow, that was incredible. I cannot wait for my commencement.
And with that, we have Sarah and Natalie with Brandon to help us sign off.
Sorry, guys. It looks like Brandon's had to take a very important phone call.
I'm a little busy. Okay. Okay, all right. Sorry, guys. I really got to go to New York. Sorry. Bye.
Oh, okay.